Good morning students, how are you all? Hope you all are fine in your houses. I am also fine students. Okay, shall we come back to our commerce lesson? In commerce we have completed seventh lesson I have completed. Then the remaining portion not available. Then in the eighth lesson fully omitted, okay, for the last year. So we will go on in the same way, okay. So I am leaving that eighth lesson and I am going to start the ninth lesson, okay, that human resource management, that unit. Here fundamentals we are going to learn about human resource management, okay. So before learning about the human resource management, here both we are learning. First we will learn about the human resource, okay, meaning of human resource. So what is human resource in a business organization? Human resource, very simple, okay. In simple words, if we say they are the employees, we can say all the men, all the human beings, those who are working in the organization, okay, are the employees of the organization. Maybe the lower level, higher level, the topmost level, all are human beings, isn't it? So we know for running a business organization, even though we have the other factors of production, men, material, money and machine, though we have all the other factors of production, men is only very important. Because the men only are going to run the organization. They are only going to operate the machines. Okay, they are only going to invest the money, the organization. Okay, so capital. Capital is also introduced either by the owners, isn't it? Or the shareholders or the owners. So all together called human resource. Okay, so the employees are the human beings of an organization. Okay, so for the success and survival of any organization, the human resource is very important. Okay, if the human resource or their quality people are there, that means they are qualified and the people are appointed, only then the business can survive and it can succeed. Otherwise they will fail, they cannot achieve their goal, isn't it? So for the success of any organization, this human resource is very important. So they have to appoint the people, those who are well qualified, well experienced, okay. Then they can give some training, so in order to improve their job performance, okay. So that is very important. Nowadays that globalization, privatization, then liberalization, all this has come. So because the whole world is considered as one, isn't it? So in order to be competitive in this world, business world, a particular organization has to run efficiently. So to run that concern efficiently, they need efficient workers, efficient management, okay. So for the even the appointment, everything we will learn in the future lessons, okay. The appointment, training, everything we are going to learn, okay. So now that we know the meaning, human resource, they are very important. We cannot avoid without men or without human resource, there is no organization at all, okay. If there is an organization, surely men are there. That means men in the sense here in this lesson, human resource, okay. So simply we cannot say human resource or simply the people, but they should have some skill and knowledge. Skilled laborers, we say, isn't it? Skill, knowledge, and that quality is among them should be very essential, okay. Or the talent, then their competencies, okay. Then they must be capable of doing some work, the capabilities. capabilities, okay, should be there, okay, because every organization is having the main purpose is to earn profit. If they have to earn profit, their human resource, their employees, okay, they must be very skilled, and the required skill set should be there. Then the knowledge what is required to run the organization must be there. Then the competencies should be there. Okay. We will learn the characteristics or the features. What are the characteristics of human resources? So we can say the main characteristics is the human resource is the only factor of production that lives. I told you many factors of production. What are the factors of production? Land, labor, capital, and organization. Land, labor, capital, and organization. Four factors of production. You might have learned in economics or in commerce, or you will learn. I think in the first year you might have learned, okay. So land we need, capital, organization. Among all these four factors of production, only the labor lives. Nothing else lives, isn't it? So the human resource is the only factor of production that lives, okay. Then what is the second point? This one is fourth one. What are the characteristics of human resource? Okay, characteristics of human resource. This one, again, this is one 2-mark question also. Okay. 2-mark question. Fourth one. Then 4-mark question. Okay, what are the characteristics? Everything we have to learn. Okay. Human resource is the only factor of production that lives. Then second one, human resource only creates other resources. Yes. Okay. All the other resources. The materials, okay, that is also one material, machine, okay, everything with all the other resources. He only has to create, he has to find out from where he can get the materials and from where he has to import the machines, or from he has to take people to bring them to the production point, okay. So human resource only creates the other resources. Third one, it is only the labor of employees. They cannot, an organization cannot hire a labor, but the labor of the employees. What is the meaning, labor of employees? Employees, that work of employees. Here labor means not the person, their work. Okay, for example, I am working in Bethlehem institution. They have hired my work only. They cannot hire myself, isn't it? I am not, we cannot say I am the slave of Bethlehem, isn't it? So they have not bought me. They are paying some amount. But do you think that that is the rate of a person for a month? No, that is the amount that they give for their work for a month, isn't it? So that is let's say that point is given, only the labor of employees is hired, not the employee himself. Okay, not the employee, but the labor of the employees is hired by the organization. And fourth one, human resource exhibit innovation and creativity. Innovation, what is that? Finding out something new. Okay, innovation. And creativity, that also some new methods of production, new techniques, that can be creativity, something but it's not available. So something newly inventing or discovering something new. Okay, innovation, but also new methods will be found out. Okay, that invention, that something is innovated or that creativity will be there only by the human resource. Human beings only will innovate something. Whether a machine, even computer cannot invent something, it cannot do anything by its own. But a man is needed. That is called human resource. Man is needed. If he wants to create something new or if he has some innovative ideas, he can put that innovative ideas through with the help of machine, maybe with the help of computer or with the help of some other machine, but not the machine cannot innovate anything. Okay, then human resource alone can think. Any machine can think? No. He can think and he can act and he can analyze something. Why? The reason. Analyze. And he can interpret. Interpretation, explanation can be given. Okay. So, for a particular year, we have received very less profit. Then they can, think why we have got less profit. And they will work, related to find out the reason for the less profit. They will act, then they will analyze. Okay, they will take the quantity of sales last year and this year and why, the reason they will find out. That is called analyzing. Then they will interpret. Okay, interpret means they will find out the reason and they will write it out. This is the reason why our income has been reduced. Okay, and human resources are emotional beings. That means, isn't it? Human beings are emotional beings. We have our own emotions, isn't it? Every time, can we work like a machine? Every time, every day when you come to school, every day you cannot be same, isn't it? Sometimes the previous day your father and mother had a quarrel, then the next day you cannot concentrate as usual, isn't it? Or you yourself may have some feverish feeling or headache, something. Then we cannot work, isn't it? Or someone, our beloved one, anyone whom we know, your grandmother, grandfather, sometime they might have expired. Then you cannot work as usual, isn't it? So we can say human resources are emotional beings. Then human resource can be motivated. They can be motivated. They can be encouraged. They can be appreciated. How? By either financially or non-financially. Okay. Financially and non-financially. Financially, they are motivated. How? Through salary. Isn't it? Salary will be given. Then non-financially, they can be appreciated, isn't it? They can be, they may say that person has done this thing and they will be appreciated by everyone. They can have a meeting, okay? So, they may be provided some promotion or, that will come under financially only, okay? So, anyway, they can be motivated. If they are motivated, a person is working for low salary, all of a sudden his salary is increased, so he is motivated. From the next day onwards, he will work very hard, isn't it? Then the behavior of the human resource are unpredictable. Yes, behavior is unpredictable, not like machines. His behavior we cannot predict, isn't it? Today I am like this, tomorrow I will become, I cannot know, isn't it? I may not know, isn't it? Sometimes I will, the behavior will be very good, or I may be emotional, or I am very, very angry towards someone. Okay, the behavior of the human resource cannot be predictable, it is unpredictable. Okay, then many years, when years goes, that means over years, the human resource gains value. Okay, over years, the human resource gains values and appreciates. Their values, that means, for example, 1 year, 2 years, if I am working continuously in the Bethlehem in higher secondary teaching commerce and accountancy, I might have gained many values, isn't it? How the Bethlehem school and here good moral, isn't it? Then discipline and all very good. What I gain, all these discipline and all, isn't it? And I gain some experience in teaching with the students of Bethlehem, isn't it? So then subject knowledge I am getting more, and how to handle the students of different characters, behaviors, isn't it? And I'll be appreciated. Okay, so over years the human resource gains values and appreciates. Then human resource are movable. Yes. Not like machines. Okay, but they are movable. Then human resource can work as a team. We cannot run many machines together, isn't it? But if a person works alone, he cannot gain more. But if he works as a team together, if we all work together, you see, that's why we ask you, isn't it? Whatever we ask you to do, you have to cooperate with us, then only we can succeed. We used to say this one. Okay, so the human resource can work as a team. If we work as a team, we can succeed, isn't it? But a machine, it will run alone, isn't it? Whether it will work more if it is many machines running together, no. But if many, if many students sitting together and you are gaining knowledge, so when we do a work as a team, as a group, we can complete it very easily. That is there, is that you may know, isn't it? So these are the characteristics. Okay, so the first question of that 5-mark question. Okay. Then 2-mark questions, 3-mark question, okay, 3-mark question. Then meanings also they have asked, what is a human resource? Okay, human resource. Human resource I will show to you, okay, so I will send the page, you have to mark this one, okay. First question, what is human resource? All human beings are considered to be human resources, but only those individuals who acquired the required skill set, talents, knowledge, competencies and capabilities in the accomplishment of both individual and organizational objectives. Then one more, human resource in organization. The human resource are the employees who are inevitable for the survival and success of the enterprise. Okay, here characteristics, 3-mark question, 4-mark question. Okay, 3-mark question. Here 2-mark question also. State 2 features of human resource management. Okay, here mention 2 characteristics of human resource. Okay, this one. Fourth question, then characteristics of human resource, 3-mark, okay, here, then characteristics of human resource, 4-mark, 3-mark, 2-mark, okay. So you study only this one. I will teach you the significance tomorrow in the next class. Okay, students, thank you very much.